David, you were the first reporter to see this one, huh?
Yeah, and George, the military standing firm tonight that Burlington should be the first base in the country to receive the F-35. We talked with the Air Guard today about what that means for the Green Mountain Boys.
We are looking forward to the decision being made, and we hope to host the F-35 here later this decade.
The final environmental impact statement released to WPTZ Thursday lists Burlington as the top choice to base the F-35.
We are a preferred alternative, so yes, there's a possibility it's going to come here. Absolutely.
Burlington outnumbers the other potential base sites in terms of people affected. 2,000 more neighbors around the airport here would see greater noise levels. The environmentally preferred site in South Carolina would affect nearly 500 fewer people. The Pentagon would now take the data to make the decision.
So there's no way that a decision has already been rendered?
According to the process, that is correct.
This process started more than a year ago with the scoping of Burlington as a potential site. Colonel Joel Clark says the Air Guard earned the top spot for many reasons, including up-to-date facilities and wide-open airspace for training.
Vermont has a proud history of flying. We have been in the flying business for 60-plus years. We've been flying fighters for 30-plus years. We've done it. We've done it well.
Over the summer, the military received nearly 11,000 comments about the fighter jet coming to Vermont. The majority were postcards from the Green Ribbons campaign in support. The bulk of written comments were in opposition. In response to many of those comments, the EIS report responds, quote, "Our opinions relative to implementing the proposed action at Burlington IAP is noted, has become part of the official project record, and contributed to the decision-making process," adding the Air Force takes environmental concerns into account.
I take great pride in hearing that they want to put it here. The Vermont Air National Guard, 1,100 airmen, are proud people who've worked very hard to maintain a reputation that has come before them.
Keep in mind the EIS itself does not mean the F-35 is coming to Vermont. The Secretary of the Air Force will make his decision in November, but they're certainly celebrating at the Air Guard tonight. The final word from the Pentagon, they're the top choice.
If it's true, it'll scare the bejesus out of a whole lot of people living near the Burlington Airport. The question is it true? As the Air Force considers its decision whether to base the new F-35 fighter in Burlington, new warnings about the risks that would follow. From Pierre Spray, a man who helped design the F-16, the aging fighter now flying at the Vermont Air National Guard.
This is a brand new fighter. All new fighters are dangerous.
And because the new planes are 40% plastic, much more than the F-16's 2%, a crash and resulting fire would present much higher risk to Burlington neighborhoods.
You have exactly the chemical warfare situation here. You know, you've got something that might crash and gas, you know, hundreds if not thousands of people.
He points to a 2008 crash of a B-2 bomber at an Air Force base in Guam, a larger plane than an F-35 with lots of composite plastic. He says it took 2 days to put out the resulting fire.
It's the kind of thing F-35 supporters don't want to hear, the governor, the mayor, the congressional delegation included. The Air Guard says if the new plane lands here, it will be safe and by then fully tested.
The Vermont Guard says by 2020, the F-35 would have plenty of flying hours on its record. Though Spray contests the Guard's arithmetic, says it's way off given the delays and slow production schedule of the new fighter. Next week, the Burlington City Council will consider whether to endorse the F-35.
But I have seen a lot of things put out in the public as fact that I think are much more scare tactics than reality.
Two Vermont Guard F-16 pilots listened to Spray's news conference, often seen shaking their heads, but saying nothing.
They referred questions to the Public Affairs Office, which issued a statement this afternoon that read, "We appreciate Mr. Spry's work on the F-16 in the late 60s and 70s. The F-35, though, offers a unique combination of capabilities, and put simply, the F-35 is the replacement aircraft."
Continuing coverage in the ongoing discussion of basing the F-35 in South Burlington.
On Tuesday, a group of opponents were in Burlington sounding off against the aircraft, literally. News Channel 5's Lauren Victory explains.
Last call. Does anybody else want earplugs?
Members of the Stop the F-35 Coalition warned bystanders of a loud demonstration, first near Burlington City Hall.
Okay, so there's the file right there.
They then blared what they said is the sound of an F-35 taking off from a Texas facility. Some grimaced as close to 115 decibels played for 6 minutes. The group says they're simulating what people will be exposed to if the F-35s are based in Burlington.
You're making so much noise, you're vibrating the stuff on my wall.
David Harrison lives across the street, and he wasn't pleased with the presentation. Jet opponents say that bolsters their argument.
You wouldn't appreciate it if you had this going on in your house.
You're absolutely right.
Thank you.
The group moved on to Montpelier.
It's really extreme. A really, really extreme sound. It's very piercing. Yeah, it's awful.
But some found it less troubling.
I could still hear the music in my Bluetooth throughout the duration of the sound.
The demos were held outside the offices of the Vermont governor and the Burlington mayor, though neither were there.
The governor's not here today. Had not planned to be here today.
Jeb Spaulding, Governor Peter Shumlin's secretary of the administration, was there, and he told coalition members this action didn't sway his support for the F-35.
We're talking about a few minutes a day, a few times a week, and that the F-35s are critical to the long-term viability and strength of the Vermont Guard. And if those planes are going to fly, they are an important part of our economy, and I think Vermonters recognize that.
In Montpelier, Lauren Victory, News Channel 5.
They're making a point in catching your attention. Some are calling them funny, others say they're vulgar. Whatever your opinion, it seems the latest debate over the fighter jet is getting sticky.
It's eye-catching.
Not F-35, F-35. It catches your eye and your ear.
We thought that there were people out there who could be brought into the coalition.
The play on the fighter jet's name stickered across Burlington for reasons not just about noise and real estate values.
We are going to spend over $1 trillion on what is going to be the most expensive weapons system in U.S. history.
The artwork calls out Vermont politicians whose names trail out from the fighter jet's engines.
So we have a sticker too.
Nicole Citro's Green Ribbons campaign supports the basing of the F-35.
You know, that's one thing that the Guard does, is protects everyone's freedom of speech.
She slapped thousands of her own stickers across Vermont.
Yeah, there's quite a bit of pro F-35 stuff out there.
With some t-shirts and hats thrown in, she says F-35s isn't about what's happening here.
So to have a conversation about what's right and what's wrong when it comes to the military, that's a separate discussion. Don't lay that at their feet. They're just trying to secure their futures.
Well, everybody's got their own opinion.
Gary Montague of Gary's Barbershop in Essex Junction has collected some stickers of his own.
We got the new stickers that just came out.
He's pro F-35. Tuesday, he was one of about 24 businesses supporting the jet who opponents named on their Facebook page. They asked you to take your business elsewhere.
You know, if you've got your own opinion, it's good. Everybody should have their own opinion. But, you know, when you start trying to hurt somebody else's livelihood, it's not good. They wouldn't want to do it to them.
A member of the Stop the F-35 Coalition says they haven't discussed any kind of boycott, so it's unclear why the businesses were listed today. What is clear, though, the anti-F-35 stickers are popular and more are being printed.
Tonight, protesters gathered inside City Hall to rally against the F-35 fighter jets ahead of tonight's meeting. The Burlington City Council will debate two resolutions that some hope, if passed, could prevent the planes from being based in Vermont. But first, they'll hear from the concerned citizens, both for and against the U.S. Air Force plan, as the council is expected to vote. WPTC's Lauren Victory joins us live tonight from City Hall. Lauren?
They are sending people to an overflow room because the City Hall auditorium is now at capacity. Needless to say, the City Council president tells me it's bound to be a long night.
It's a side opening instead of a bottom opening.
Carmen Sargent estimates she spent $100,000 to make her home accessible for her disabled daughter.
This was really the first thing we did when she was little because her wheelchair wouldn't fit in the bathroom anymore.
They've lived in their South Burlington home for 41 years. They fear making it to 50 years in the neighborhood won't be a possibility.
I was hoping to have a home that my daughter could keep.
The sergeants live about a minute's drive from the airport and the Vermont Air National Guard base, where the U.S. Air Force is considering basing its new F-35 jets. The military concedes the plane is louder than the current Burlington-based F-16s. Sergeant worries it'll be so loud she'll have to sell her home.
We all knew there was an airport here when we moved here. What we didn't know is that there was an expanding military presence.
But as much as Sargent doesn't want the F-35 to be based here,
I think they're nervous.
There are people who are really pushing for the plane. At Gary's Barbershop in Essex Junction, owner Gary Montague's been cutting hair for nearly 50 years. He and other jet supporters worry no F-35 will mean no base and no business in the region. He says he usually gives haircuts to 10 to 15 Guard members a day.
After a year, it's a lot of money.
Guard officials haven't said if the base will close without the F-35s, but admit the future isn't clear. That fear of the unknown is what's rattling many who've built their lives and businesses in the greater Burlington area.
Big time. That's big time, yeah.
Now, tonight's public forum is supposed to have started just a few minutes ago. The city council president tells me she expects to take those public comments till about 8 o'clock tonight. That's when she says the councilors will take it to a vote.
Two votes, and the council saying no to both of those, no in getting in the way of the F-35 from coming to the city's airport. The first resolution tonight about banning the fighter jet from Burlington failed 4-10. The second, about asking the Pentagon to hold off basing the plane here in the coming years while putting in place noise restrictions, failed 3-11. Tonight, nearly 500 people crammed into Contoy's auditorium, a lasting effort to stop or promote the potential basing of the F-35. F-35 supporters and opponents filled Contoy's auditorium, each with their own battle cry. Just like Monday night, sway city council onto their side.
Please stand with the majority of the people of this city, our region, and our state, and vote against any resolution that's against the Vermont Air Guard or against the basing of the F-35.
We can be pro Vermont Air National Guard, we can be pro airport, and we can also be pro business in Burlington, but be against the F-35s.
Counselors were even greeted with the sound of the jet.
You're taking the time of your neighbors.
Are all of you feeling this? This is anger, and this is what people will feel every time they hear that airplane take off.
Hearing that noise meant job security for these Air Guard members and their families.
For those that believe, as I do, that the freedoms and opportunities available in this great nation are so precious that it's worth bearing arms to defend, I'm proud to call you neighbors.
But a threat to safety and health for others.
To say you have to put up with a weapon of mass destruction in your backyard if you want jobs is to hold people hostage.
Councillor Rachel Siegel says the panel should ban the fighter jet because she says the F-35 doesn't help Vermonters.
They need more helicopters. First strike planes are not going to help our community.
But Councillor Chip Mason disagrees, saying the legal implications of banning the plane could be disastrous.
This administration and this council have been working diligently to dig us out of the hole, and I'm not going to make the hole bigger.
Opponents say the process tonight was rigged so that supporters would get to speak. Councilors say they wanted to hear from Burlington residents and those who hadn't spoken to them before. South Burlington City Councilor Roseanne Greco made some comments to a local newspaper about that. She says she's concerned about materials in the F-35 and the possibility that they could burn and harm neighbors if there were a crash. She says the probability of an accident is higher because the planes are still in their testing phase. The quote, though, not sitting well with some.
I hope it doesn't really represent what you mean. Otherwise, you're just an unconscionable harmless monster.
It's just one of the messages South Burlington City Councilor and F-35 opponent Roseanne Greco says she received since Friday.
They were pretty nasty.
Comments following a quote in a newspaper saying, "It's a matter of where it's going to crash. I am really hoping it crashes soon so that we see what happens when it goes down, so we don't witness it if it went down here.
I hope it never crashed, but it is going to crash. And when it does crash, I want it to crash before it gets here, you know, when it's in testing."
Emails have since poured into Greco's mailbox. One reading, "You make me sick in every way a human can. You are an evil person."
The first reaction was surprise. The second reaction was just sadness.
Now police are getting involved, worried about retaliation at her home. Last year, someone put pro F-35 stickers all over Greco's mailbox. She was able to peel them off, but there was another case of vandalism that she says wasn't so easy to fix.
We donated a bench in honor of our dog Charlie, who died a few years ago, and we had Charlie's name on there, but he has hyphenated last name, which the first one's my name, somebody ripped it off.
Greco says she stands by her comment that the plane should be tested more if it indeed comes to Burlington, and she says she's aware she's become a target.
They came to the house twice, so they can easily come again, you know, but I'm not going to obsess about it. I'm not going to become paranoid. I'm just going to be vigilant.
South Burlington police say officers are checking on Greco's neighborhood a little more than usual to ensure her safety.
Breaking news coverage from WPTZ News Channel 5. We have now confirmed that the U.S. Air Force has decided to send the F-35 fighter jet to the Vermont Air National Guard station at the Burlington Airport. Details are expected to come from the Vermont Guard later today, but sources have confirmed the Air Force's decision. Once again, WPTZ News Channel 5 has learned the Air Force has decided to send the F-35 fighter jet to Burlington.
WPTZ's George Mallet here joining you live with breaking news. As WPTZ first reported this morning, sources confirm the U.S. Air Force has decided to base the F-35 fighter jets in Vermont. The Air Force is about to hold a news conference. To give us more details, let's check in with WPTZ's Stuart Ledbetter live there at the news conference. Stu, fill us in.
Well, George, we're in a big hangar at the airport. There are hundreds of Air and Army National Guardsmen here. We're awaiting a news conference featuring General Stephen Cray, the commander of the National Guard, along with Governor Shumlin and Senator Leahy.
I know you will tomorrow. Thank you very, very much. I know you will tomorrow. Thank you very, very much.
There you have it, Vermont Senior Senator Patrick Leahy heaping praise on the Green Mountain Boys and making the worst-kept secret in the military-industrial complex official. The F-35's indeed coming to Vermont to be based along with the Green Mountain Boys. Opponents have vowed to take legal action, but at this hour, it seems very unclear what options they might actually have and whether that might in fact be an exercise in futility. The decision, as you just saw, has the universal support of Vermont's entire congressional delegation, as well as Governor Peter Shumlin. We're going to continue with this online at WPTZ.com if you want to check in there and see the rest of the news conference. But we'll have full team coverage for you coming up tonight, beginning on WPTZ First at 5.
WPTZ News Channel 5 broke the story this morning.
And tonight, extended team coverage on what this means for the Guard and the economy, including a sit-down interview with Adjutant General Stephen Cray and a live report from David Schneider in Winooski on what F-35 opponents plan next.
Yeah, but we're going to begin at the Guard base in South Burlington. WPTZ's Stuart Ledbetter is standing by there. Stu.
Well, good evening. That's right. The Air Force confirming this morning that Burlington and Hill Air Force Base in Utah are the first in line to get this new plane. The F-35 is built by Lockheed Martin. It's part of the most expensive weapon system in U.S. history. If you do the numbers, it means that about $2 billion worth of hardware is coming our way. At the airport, the commander of the Vermont National Guard celebrating with his airmen and women. News: the airbase here is first in line for the Pentagon's newest fighter jet, the F-35.
This is a milestone event for the Air Force and its next step in securing the citizens of the United States.
The controversial new fighter, still in testing in Florida, is expected to land here in the year 2020. The Air Force selecting Burlington for its strategic location and airspace and relatively cheap transitional costs.
I know you are proud to serve. Are you especially proud today?
Senator Leahy was beaming, said he pushed the Pentagon toward Burlington, but insisted the decision was based on merit. A decision that should ensure decades of stability for the 1,100 jobs now tied to the Air National Guard base here. But the new jets are louder than the aging fleet of F-16s they'll replace, according to the Air Force, a sensitive issue for thousands of people living in the suburban neighborhoods nearby.
And we will continue, as we have, to work with our communities to be good neighbors.
For Winooski, divided over the new planes and added noise.
Yes, the announcement was made the F-35 is coming today. That doesn't stop the discussions that will go on, will continue to need to go on for the next 6 or 7 years.
For now, though, the Guard is celebrated.
This is an endorsement of your dedication, your service, your hard work, and your effectiveness in protecting the greatest democracy in the land.
Now, the airbase is going to need between $3 and $4 million worth of infrastructure improvements here, modifications, in order to house the F-35. And the Vermont pilots are going to need some additional training, a few months anyway, but not until we get closer to the actual transition date, now expected in 2020. News Channel 5's David Charnes was on hand today for the breaking news. He's since had an opportunity to sit down with the commanding officer here. David, what do we know?
Well, it's been certainly a long day for General Stephen Cray. He got the word about this early this morning, thinking about what the F-35 means for his community all day. He spoke exclusively with WPTZ News Channel 5 this afternoon, and he says that he's just looking toward the future.
I am ecstatic the fact that Vermont Air National Guard has been chosen as the first Air National Guard base in the country to base the F-35.
Adjutant General Stephen Cray says he never knew for sure the Pentagon would base the F-35 in Vermont. His fleet of 18 F-16s will be replaced by 18 new F-35s in 2020. The decision comes after a four-year scoping process out of Washington.
I believed it was the right decision before they started it. I certainly believe that it was the right decision now.
The news, a big one tonight. 18 F-35s coming to the Air Guard base here in South Burlington in 2020. Question remains, though, will an F-35 fly over these skies before then? Stu, the general tells me tonight that he just doesn't know that answer yet.
Well, there are a lot of unanswered questions here. It's only day one, but it's something we'll continue to follow. For now, we're live at the Green Mountain Boys Air Guard base in South Burlington. Stuart Ledbetter with David Charnes. Back to you in the studio.
Thank you, gentlemen. And the Air Guard and Stephen Cray obviously very excited about today's news, but opponents of the plane say they're still prepared to fight the fighter jets off.
News Channel 5's David Schneider is live in Winooski with their reaction tonight. David.
Well, the first reaction, certainly not one of surprise. Opponents both here in Winooski and beyond say they've expected this news, and they say they've prepared to dig in their heels and fight it every way they can.
F-35 opponent James Mark Leese watched as the Vermont National Guard announced it would be a new base for the F-35.
This decision is really incredibly negative for so many thousands of people around the airport.
Leese and other opponents have long been worried about noise from the jet.
Now we've really got to unite to fight this. And we have many ways to fight it. The Air Force is not the final decision maker. They're just warning us. The courts are going to be weighing in.
After the announcement, a lawyer for the coalition told News Channel 5 he'll file a complaint in federal court claiming the Air Force did not carry out the environmental impact statement correctly. Opponents also want to see more information about the basing decisions and want Vermont's Act 250 environmental permitting process to come into play.
I think that will be enough for the Air Force to decide to base elsewhere. But you never know.
Meanwhile, Winooski residents, like state lawmaker George Cross, say the city is split between those who support the Guard and those worried louder jets could hurt the community. Cross says the delegation should have listened more.
It would certainly have been nicer for all parties, I think, had the politicians agreed to have met with the opponents early, very early in the game, when groups first raised issues about this. As opposed to simply stonewalling them.
Now, at the Guard today, Leahy responded to some of those claims, saying he has been talking to people on both sides all throughout the process. Now, as for some of the legal action being taken by the oppositions, whatever the courts decide will likely be appealed the first time around, which, of course, would send the case to the Supreme Court. Live in Winooski, David Schneider, WPTZ News Channel 5.
Continuing coverage now, WPTZ broke the news yesterday that 18 F-35s are coming to Vermont. And now we have the official document laying out the reasons why the Pentagon made that decision. WPTZ's David Charnes has the details.
The Deputy Secretary of the Air Force made the call Monday. With his signature on the record of decision, 18 F-35s are on their way to Burlington. The document lists reasons why the Vermont Air Guard Station will get the planes in 2020. The Deputy Secretary writing, Burlington Air Guard Station was selected because it presents the best mix of infrastructure, airspace, and overall cost to the Air Force. The Pentagon also notes the Green Mountain Boys have the oldest fleet of F-16s out of the other guard stations that were in the running, and that no additional manpower will be required to fly the F-35. Also written in the decision, how to mitigate noise once the F-35 lands here. The document acknowledges noise from the plane is unavoidable and that some of the noise effects could be considered adverse or annoying to potentially affected individuals. According to military scoping documents, noise-wise, the F-35 will affect thousands more people around the guard station than the current fleet of F-16s. The Air Force must come up with a plan of action for noise mitigation within the next 3 months. And once the planes arrive, the Guard is being asked to do another noise study, train in simulators as much as possible, and avoid flying at lower altitudes during what the Secretary calls seasonally sensitive ranching and recreational activities, along with holidays. Safety is briefly mentioned, with the Deputy Secretary stating the Air Force will develop emergency fuel dumping procedures and work with local fire departments on what to do if there's a crash. You can read the entire document on our website, WPTZ.com. In Burlington, I'm David Charnes, WPTZ News Channel 5.
So the basing decision is made, but the opposition will continue to fight to get it reversed or at least reconsidered. News Channel 5's Stuart Ledbetter is standing by with details on that part of the story tonight. Stu.
Well, a day after the big decision, Stephanie, the Stop the F-35 coalition was outlining three angles of attack through the courts. Even as city leaders were pledging to do more to shield those living near the airport from jet noise, which some insisted today has never been worse.
George Malay has battled the airport for years over the noise that spills into his neighborhood.
How's that sound to you?
It's loud, and it's typical.
F-16 fighters were taking off as we talked. Commercial flights, he says, already keep him from getting more than 4.5 hours of sleep, and he worries the F-35s will only make it worse.
I believe it was a foregone conclusion that the F-35s are coming here. There were far too many political manifestations.
Congratulations.
A day after jubilant politicians celebrated news the Guard will get the F-35 at the end of the decade, opponents said the process was rigged against them.
And I'm really disappointed in our congressional delegation. It's all about money and power, really. And I obviously have neither of those things, so I don't really count.
Still, the legal fight is not over. Opponents demanding state courts require an Act 250 permit for the airport before the new jets land here.
In addition, lawyers for the opposition plan to file suit in the next month or so in federal court, claiming a violation of the National Environmental Policy Act. Basically, they'll claim that the Air Force Secretary made his decision based on flawed and incomplete data on the real impact the F-35 will have on the surrounding neighborhoods.
Remember that we have considerable work to do to improve the quality of life in the neighborhoods.
And city leaders are sending a message. They'll try hard to mitigate jet noise, which could mean new brick walls or berms where scores of blighted homes near the runways are now coming down.
You think it'll work?
I hope so. You know, the best science that's out there is the science that we're going to use.
Both Pam McKenzie and Mayor Weinberger wanted the F-35s badly, both now extending the olive branch to neighbors who will most feel the impact should they land.